Now, as all the Indians know, India is the second most populous country of the world. Okay, so first populous is China, but China's population is good, is, you know, promising according to its size. But India's population is rising year by year, and you know, for the growth of the country, it is not very good that its population is very large. So let's see how the population in India affects India. So first comes population size and distribution. Now, population size and distribution is according to two kinds, that is by number and by density. So by number, by numbers we can count the population. Now, how can we state population or count population by number? So enumeration of population in some period of time or in some years is known as census, and this census is held in India every 10 years. So according to census of 2011, India's population is 1,210.6 million, like 1,210.6 million. So India's population is very large, and India's area is only 32.8 kilometer square. So this is about by numbers India's population. India accounts 16.6% of total world's population, and India's some states such as Uttar Pradesh is the highly populated state. Sikkim is lowest populated state with only 5 lakh population, and Lakshadweep Island has only 60,000 population. Okay, 60,000 people population. Then comes by density. Now by density means according to the number of people per square kilometer. So this number by density varies from place to place and area to area, but the round off we can do, right? So in India there is 1102 people per kilometer square, like 1102 people per kilometer square. So India is very highly populated state, like so many population is present in India. So yeah, and Uttar Pradesh and Sikkim, their population density will vary, obviously. Okay, then comes India's population growth and process of population change. Population growth and process of population change. Now, population change means it can be in positive way and it can be in negative way. It means population can be increased or can be decreased. While population growth means population is growing day by day. But in India, we will only consider about population growing, because in India, population is only growing. Like in some years, growth rate is, you know, less, and we means population growth rate should decline in India now for its well-being. Okay, so population growth depends upon the population growth depends upon factors such as its birth rate, and population change depends upon various factors, that is birth. First, let's start with birth rate. Now, what is birth rate? Number of births in 1,000 people is known as its birth rate. In particular time, that is known as its birth rate. And birth rate nowadays are declining, and death rate nowadays are also declining. So the growth rate will decline. Now, what are death rates? Death rates are the number of deaths in 1,000 people in particular time. So yeah, this is what death rate means. And death rate and birth rate both are declining nowadays. So growth rate will decline, and hopefully India will become sufficient for its population. Yeah. Then comes migration. Now people also migrate from one state to another. That affects the density of population, and people migrate from one nation to another nation, that affects the country's population. Okay, so if outsiders come and settle in India, then population will increase, and if they will go, then population will decrease. So this is what migration means. Then comes age composition. Now age composition is children, adult and senior citizen. Now children are below 15, adults are till 36 and and then comes the age of working population. Working population is from 36 to 50, and after 50, after 65, they are senior citizens. So this is age composition. Then sex ratio, that means the number of women per 1,000 male. So Kerala has, Kerala and Tamil Nadu, they have higher number of women per 1,000 male, but in rest of the country, that is very sad that the sex ratio for women is low, as the women's are lower per 1,000 male. So this was about sex ratio. Then comes literacy rate. Now literacy rate means the people who are, literacy means people, they are able to read, write and learn any one language properly. So this was about literacy rate, and in India literacy rate is rising day by day, but sadly it is lower than it is, it should be. So vulnerable groups are the deprived ones, that is SC, SC, STs, scheduled castes, scheduled tribes and other backward castes. And also women are having low literacy rate, but nowadays women are growing. Okay, then comes occupational structure. Occupational structure means primary activity, secondary activity and tertiary activity. Now India, as India is a developing country, so people are more engaged in primary sector. The country which are developed ones, if India wants to be developed country, then people should start engaging in the secondary and tertiary activities. Now primary activity, secondary activity, tertiary activity. Primary activity are production activity, secondary activity are manufacturing activity, and tertiary activity are external or production or advertising activity, we can say. Yeah, so this was about occupational structure. Then comes health. Now population growth and change mainly depends on health, because if population is not healthy, then it would not be an asset for the country, it would be a liability for the country. So people needed to be healthy. Okay, then comes adolescent population. Adolescent population in India is very high nowadays. Like adolescent means from 13 to 18 years, they are known as adolescents. So adolescent population in India is high. Okay, then comes national population policy. National population policy states that population should be in control, and birth rate, death rate, migration, these all factors are being seen in the national population policy 2000. Yeah, so this was all about the population of India. I hope you like this video. Please give it a thumbs up. Also comment down if there are any suggestions. Share this video as much as possible. Subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you can get my latest updates. Thank you.